Hey, welcome back. My name is Joseph, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Facebook's aggregated event measurement. Okay, so maybe you've set up your website, you've verified it, you've set up your pixel, and now Facebook is telling you you need to set up something else. You're not quite sure what it is, but if you don't set it up, then you won't be able to report or track what's happening with your Facebook ads. Well, if that's the case, this video is for you. I'm going to go to my screen now and show you how to set it up. It's pretty simple. It's so painless. There's a few things that I'll point out as we do it, but let's go ahead and jump on in. All right, we're at my screen right now. And what I want to show you is I'm in Business Manager. So if you haven't set that up, make sure you've done it. There's a few other things that we need to do. So I've already verified my website with Facebook and I've already set up a pixel. So from within your Business Manager, what we want to do is click on these three, and it depends on what UI you have. Sometimes Facebook will have it one way for other users and another way for another users. But if you have this hamburger menu right here, you really want to click that. It might be three dots, whatever it is. You want to click this so that these shortcuts show up. At this point, you can either click Events Manager if it's right there for you. If it's not, you can go ahead and scroll down and always find a shortcut that's not here, somewhere lower in this menu. But for now, we're gonna click Events Manager. And before we go, and while that's loading, I wanna talk a little bit about Events Manager. Events Manager is where we set up the pixel in the previous video, but what we're doing right now, and let me go ahead and make my screen a little bit bigger for you. So what we wanna do right now is make sure that when you're running an advertisement and you wanna track your conversions, that when someone goes to your website, either it's on their phone or it's on a desktop or any type of device, that when they come to your website, you can actually say this person visited a page, they completed a registration, they became a lead. Now, once that happens on your website, we want to send information back to Facebook. And on Facebook, we want them to record what a person did and then give us some type of return on your ad spend. In order to do that, we have to set this up. If you don't set it up, then Facebook's not gonna be able to track things right, and in some cases, they'll turn off your ads. So here we go. In the last video, or in one of the previous videos, depending on the order you're watching this in, you'll see that we set up two pixels. Now, one of the pixels we set up, I haven't actually connected that with the website. So I'll go ahead and leave a link up here so that you can make sure that you figure out how to connect it with your website. But if you've already connected it with your website, what you want to do is click on the pixel that you know is working. It will also show you here that there are some events that people have been to the website or something has happened. Once you're on this page, this right here is for the pixel. It's a data source that's sending information from your web property back to Facebook. We want to click on this where it says new, aggregated event measurement. Once you click that, we're gonna get this blue button here that says configure web event. This is extremely important that we actually have the website set up and verified, because if you do, then it's already gonna be here. So mine are blurred out right now just for a little privacy, even though this is a demo account. Your website, whatever the address, will show up right here. So what I'm gonna do is you can either click the arrow or click directly on the web address here. Once you click it, you'll get this little button right here. I wish that they would make it more easy to see, but essentially it just says manage events. Click on manage events. It'll give you this message that essentially if you make a change or if you make the wrong change, some of your ads can be paused for 72 hours if you aren't doing this. But then you also want to make sure, when I was actually first setting up a few months ago, what I noticed is that Facebook actually was taking a long time before things would work. And I was like, hey, what's going on? So this message can be helpful, but pretty much if you change event configurations, it could take up to 72 hours to allow for those changes to take effect. Some changes may cause ads and ad sets to no longer run. So just be mindful of what you're doing here. But if you haven't run any ads, you don't really have anything to worry about. We're gonna click edit. All right, so now what we have here, and once again, so my domain is actually blurred out, but this is going to be your website domain here. And what we want to do is actually start configuring the events that we want to send back to Facebook. So let me add a few to give you an idea of how that could work. So let's go ahead and click this green button here where it says add event. And the first event that I want to do, you'll see here that it says high priority and lowest priority. So I'm adding an event that's going to be a lower priority than a lead. So in your business, in most cases, a lead is going to be a higher priority than someone that does an action like view a page. So the first thing that we have is we have our priority, then we have the actual pixel or custom conversion. Maybe some of you have custom conversion set up, then the type of event that we're going to set up. So the first thing we do is we pick our pixel. So I'm going to pick the pixel that is set up and I'm going to pick the event name. Now, the one that I want to start with, just so that you kind of get an idea here, is I'm selecting view content. So I want the highest priority Facebook to report that. In some cases, if a person doesn't become a lead, Facebook might just send back view content that, hey, this person came to your website, they weren't a lead, we're going to send that back. But what Facebook is also telling us that, and you can go through and read some of this, is that if a person views content and they become a lead, we can go ahead and assume that they viewed content before giving us their name and their email address. So let's just say we have those two, but let's go ahead and add one more, and I'll show you what we can even drag these around a bit. So what's something else that they might do before they view content or becoming a lead? They might even complete registration. If you have e-commerce, they might search on our site for something. So there's tons of different activities, but let's go ahead and add a few more. So let's say that someone that's coming to our website that might purchase something, they may add to cart, and then they may also add payment information after they add to cart. And then we'll put one more just to give you some ideas so that you understand how this could look. Maybe they're going to go ahead and complete registration. We might even have purchase. So let's just go ahead and use a purchase. So some of yours might look like this, to where we care more about what actions they're actually doing. So if you have an e-commerce site, or maybe you're selling your speaking courses or coaching courses, whatever the case may be, you might care about someone viewing your content less than you would them becoming a lead. But if they're actually going to add information to their cart and add payment information, you might care more about these two than them being a lead. But if you don't, you can switch places. But at the top, I'm going to put purchases, because if you're actually selling anything on your website, any type of e-commerce or courses that you're selling, I'm pretty sure that's likely going to be the highest one. So if this is the way that we set up, we can add up to 8 different events. And you can see here that it says event slots filled 5 of 8. So I can add 8 more if I want. So kind of think about your business. Think about what's important to you, the order and priority that you want them, and then you add those here. All right, so the next thing is, once we have everything set up the way we want, we're going to click submit. It's going to give us a little message here. We have to confirm these changes. But all this is saying is confirm updates to domain event configuration, updates to new events, and this configuration take effect immediately. So as soon as I do this, if you had something else set up, or if you have an event that is, let's say that you're doing a custom conversion for a particular campaign and you don't add that here, then that campaign would be shut off. And that's the message that we were seeing earlier, is that these events have to be about ads that you're running. Yes, I confirm these changes. I understand I must wait 72 hours to change these events again. So once I put these in place, I'm going to need to wait 72 hours. So hopefully I'm good, but this is just a demo account. So I'll click apply. Gives me a successful message. Event configuration changes will be applied to this website. You must wait 72 hours before you change again. I click OK and I'm set up. All right, and that's it. That's all you had to do to set up your aggregated event management. So let me know how that went for you. If you like this content, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit the like, let YouTube know, hey, this is great content. We want more people to see it. But let me know if there's something that I left out, drop that in the comments. I'd be glad to make sure that we get your questions answered. So until next time, take care. I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.